Okay, another video coming up now. This is at the Big Wheel in Brighton. Definitely no chemtrails now, too dark, but it might be fun. Let's see what happens. What's that? Oh, right, yeah.
About the twin.
It's about the Twin Towers. You know the Twin Towers?
Yeah.
It didn't quite happen how we thought it was, so I'm trying to let people look into it themselves and see if, let them decide what they think might or might not be true, yeah?
Why?
Because 2,000 people lost their lives in there, and if it didn't happen how it said, then a proper investigation should be done.
There's a lot of people think that it was the government that done it.
You know
that?
Yeah.
Well,
so,
I don't know.
Yeah.
So there's no improvement.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. And without a proper investigation to kind of look into it, no one can really make their minds up. But there's no way that those two towers and a third tower fell because a couple of planes hit them. They were thick iron, thicker than. Sturdier than that would have been a tiny little piece of iron in that thing, and the thing just went down into dust. So,
why is everybody sort of starting it up now though, or if you go like you, why have you, how many years is it now? 10, 11 years, isn't it?
Or?
We went out there when it happened.
Oh, did you?
We booked up to go, and then we went and unbooked it and come back, and then we thought, well, we didn't know what to do, and then they. So you won't get another chance of us, so we're back to it again. And I thought, well, it's got to be the safest time to go. Because everybody will be on alert. So we've went. When we come back, there was somebody that said, well, it was the government. And I mean, why would you do that? Why would they put their own people? I know, initially you could think that because, I mean, it doesn't seem to make sense.
But it also, when you look at the official story, it doesn't make sense either that these 16 guys in a cave, of which 7 have been found alive afterwards anyway, could get through the American air defence system and everything else. And the lack of evidence, like with the Pentagon, there was no plane ever found.
Yeah, because that was another one, wasn't it? Yeah, there was no plane ever found at the Shanksville one
where they went into the ground.
No.
And no planes have ever been found at the Twin Towers. No evidence at all. So it needs looking into, basically. We can't actually say who did it, really, but...
That's what I'm saying, it's just trying to go now, though, isn't it? How are they going to find evidence now?
Well, people have been fighting to get the truth out, and professional people, not just people like me on a bike. But, you know, governments don't listen. I mean, you can see with the Jimmy Savile thing, right? It's corrupt. Yeah. We're in corruption. Yeah. And David Icke, funny enough, said Jimmy Savile was what he was years ago, and everyone laughed at him. And because when you actually try and complain about it, nobody listens. At the time, the Dunblane guy who killed all those children in Dunblane. There's a secrecy, a denotice on that for 100 years. Because they know what he was and who was with him, but they don't want it to come out because politicians might be implicated.
Because it's to do with children again. Yeah.
So, and the social services are always snatching children away from families at the slightest drop of a hat, and yet when there's something really serious happening to a child, they don't see it.
Yeah.
You know, these terrible cases of children. Yeah, they're snatching them off into the homes, and then it's terrible. So it's all linked anyway. Same people.
Yeah, well, somebody did say that to me, you know, a long time ago, and I went, no, they wouldn't do it.
Yeah.
They would kill all those people for what reason though? Would they kill them? You say they wouldn't do that. They went to Iraq
and pepper bombed Iraq and killed over 500,000 people. They don't care about killing anyone.
But I can't actually see the point. Why would you kill people that are working in a tower that are going to work?
Well, the two towers were full of asbestos, so they were at the end of their life anyway. They were bought by a guy called Larry Silverstein for almost nothing. And when those towers came down, Larry Silverstein made billions of pounds out of the whole transaction. When you really look into 9/11 and you think, oh, that can be true, that can be true. When you see all the different pieces, you can see the big picture of how it happened, Deutsche Bank, they do this thing called, this is quite technical stuff, but they do things called put options where people can bet when shares go down. And Deutsche Bank put shares on American Airlines the night before that their shares would go down, and of course they did, because they were the planes involved. So there's it's all a big, there's a little few people at the top that are controlling you and I, and making our life, like now we're surrounded basically, I feel like I'm in a book from Big Brother, with all the cameras watching me all the time, and what, these poor kids, what jobs have they got facing, you know, futures with McDonald's and all this stuff?
That's right,
it's not learning nothing, are they?
No.
But they're raking in the money for the people at the top again. So,
do you think you're doing any good?
I met you today.
I've been talking to you for one, but I don't know whether you've got anybody else talking.
Yeah, I get a lot of people talking to me. Most of it is positive. I've got a couple of negatives where a guy said, I lost my son in Afghanistan. I said, well, yeah, that's why I'm trying to stop the next one happening.
Yeah.
But he couldn't get to grips with that. He just thought I was berating his son's name because he was. Yeah. And I said, no, I'm not that, but you have to face up to.
But I think they should lose the war anyway, because they will never ever win. Because I watched the programme on the television a couple of days ago, and I was absolutely astounded. Somebody was in Kenya and then Somalia.
Yeah.
And what I found out was that the Somalia is run. They've had a lot of trouble out there, and they're now run by the warlords.
Yep.
And the warlords and the pirates have got so much money, and they're in cahoots with Al Qaeda.
Yeah.
And I said to my husband, all the time they've got all that money coming in, they'll never get rid of us.
You and I have got to do stuff for these kids to have a future.
That's right,
otherwise, they're going to be walking into.
Yeah.
God knows what. So we got to say, right, you people at the top, you're obviously rotten, you've got to go.
Yeah.
You know, leave our kids alone, stop killing people. Yeah. You know, the whole thing, really. Anyway, good talking to you. Your kid, you look like you're getting cold now.
Yeah, we're waiting for Grandad to come back to the car now.
Well, I might hang around here for a bit, because the guy over here likes a bit of reggae, so that's what I put it on. If he's working, I think he is, he's up there somewhere.
Yeah.
It's just really a bit of, you know, if we can, it's all about people's consciences and changing minds.
Yeah.
And if we don't have to get violent, but we can change things with our minds if we're all aware of what's happening. Like, aware of people like Jimmy Savile.
Yeah.
Without them introducing laws that actually infringe on us as families. Because that's what they do, they'll find a problem and then they make, like they'll say, oh, we got terrorism, and the next thing you know, you've got to walk around with ID cards.
Yeah, that's right.
But they caused the terrorism in the first place.
Exactly.
So it's like a trick.
Yeah.
Hey, enjoy your night anyway.
Okay, see you later.
See you later. Thanks for the chat, yeah? Yeah. That's pretty interesting. Good little chat there. I hope it came out on a video. See what happens.